Let's talk about something else that's not going to help you out very much, and that is that the Climate Council believes that we should ban all petrol cars by 2035. Now, yes, you have heard this before. The ACT is planning on doing it, but now it should be every vehicle in the country electric, according to the Climate Council. The Climate Council, by the way, was set up in part by our great mate Tim Flannery, who once said that, you know, the rain that falls will never fill the dams. Anyone who's living in New South Wales would be aware that that wasn't quite the case over the weekend. So forget about your petrol car. You've got to get rid of it. If you've got two cars, the Climate Council says, you've got to go down to one car so that, you know, all the other times you're riding a bike or walking or going on public transport. Now, Chris Bowen, he has been listening. He has been listening. We should give him credit. He is going to fix all of this because, of course, we know he's going to put in an electric vehicle charger every 150 kilometres.
A lot of people are thinking about buying an EV, worried about whether there's enough chargers. We're rolling out a charger once every 150 kilometres on our national highway network to make sure no matter where you want to drive, no matter how far you drive, there's going to be a charger there for you.
Well, to the Climate Council, I say, I very much look forward to more scenes like this, which we saw over Easter, of course, where, you know, people were driving from Adelaide to Melbourne and vice versa and needed to charge their cars, and there's a line of a dozen of them just sitting there waiting for their opportunity to juice up. Of course, that was in Keith in South Australia, which is about an hour away from the Victorian border. Anyone who'd gone to the servo and filled up their Prado would have been in Victoria by the time the person at the back of that line actually had an opportunity to charge their car. But look, it's all good, you know. We were told, according to the now federal government, when they were in opposition to boost their climate targets, their net zero targets, they said that by 2030, 89% of car sales in this country would be electric vehicles. The Federal Transport Department now says it's going to be 27%. It's pretty clear why they've got to ban petrol cars, because nobody wants to buy them, or wants to buy electric cars, I mean. You've got to be forced into it.
And, of course, we've got to ban everyone from having a petrol vehicle to save the planet. We could, you know, for example, get government ministers to travel on the same jet to the same function. That would be unrealistic. Better for everyone else to pay in their car.